I get so many questions on how to maintain your Ender 3. The most important area to focus on is the filament path, the extruder, the PTFE tube, the hot end, and the nozzle. This is where most of the problems occur. And if you maintain it, you'll have better prints. And I'll show you how to do it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. My buddy Angus over at the Maker's Muse channel, he did a great video on how he maintains his Ender 3 and gave some great tips. I'll link to that up here somewhere and also in the description below. But there's one area that was different, is he had direct drive installed on his Ender 3. Where most people, I think, have the Bowden setup, at least that's the way it comes stock. And there's some different things that you need to take care of on this that maybe you wouldn't do on a direct drive. It's far more important, at least. So that's what I'm going to focus on, because if you get these right, you literally will see better prints, less stringing, cleaner edges, everything. I get so many emails asking me, how do I fix this problem or that problem? And almost always comes back to these simple tips I'm going to show you. The first step is to take the filament out of the filament path. So preheat the hot end, push a little filament out once it's heated up, and then pull it all the way out so it's completely out so you can actually remove the filament from the machine. Next, while it's still warm, we're going to unscrew this coupling and then pull the PTFE out of the hot end. But before you do that, put your finger near the top of the hot end. If it's really hot, you don't want to keep your finger there, or if it's really warm, this is a sign your fan may be failing. It may be spinning and blowing air, but it's not blowing enough. So that's a sign that we may have another issue and may have to replace the fan. But for right now, we're going to unscrew the coupling and then pull it out of the hot end. And if you look at mine, there's a little bit of filament down at the bottom. Now it's not blocking, but it's stuck to the inside of the PTFE tube, and it's right there where it touches the nozzle. When you pull it out, you'll always see a little bit of filament there, but when you see it all the way around on the inside like this, that's a sign that the PTFE tubing is losing some of its lubrication right down where it touches the nozzle because it's so hot. And what happens is as that builds up, that's going to affect retraction, slow the filament down from retracting, and also going the other direction, so you'll end up with gaps in your prints. And you'll really notice it as little strings on your print, like these flags that I'm showing here. See the little strings going across the flags? Those shouldn't be there. That's a sign that the PTFE tubing is starting to fail. Now, sometimes you remove it and you'll see the end of that PTFE tubing is black. That means it's burned and it's shot. That's never going to work. It's going to give you terrible retraction results and terrible prints. So you need to get that fixed. You can replace whole PTFE tubing, but an easy way is just cut off the last 20 millimeters. A tubing cutter like this from Capricorn, it's got a nice notch to hold the PTFE tubing so you get a clean cut. And just cut that last 20 millimeters off, screw it back on, and then push it all the way down to the nozzle, and you're ready to start printing again. How often should you do this? Well, on my print farm back here, which is running almost every day, I do it about once a month. I go across the machines, clip off that 20 millimeters, put it back in, and start printing again. But it depends on what temperature you're running at, how big your prints are, and how often you're printing. So if you're just average printing, you could probably get away with once every 2 or maybe 3 months that you have to cut that off. But when you do, I highly suggest you also replace the nozzle. Again, while it's still hot, you can replace the nozzle very easily. And I like to use this thumb ratchet. I'll put a link to this in the description below. It's really inexpensive. And then I use a 1/4 inch socket. Now, I think it's a 6.5 millimeter, but I just use a 1/4 inch socket here in the US and it fits really nice. It's a little bit loose, which is fine. I'm not stripping anything, but it stops me from over tightening as well. So I can just ratchet this thing on or off and keeps my fingers away from the heat. So replace the nozzle, and I buy these sets. I have this nice set that I got on Amazon. I'll put a link to this in the description below. You get 25 0.4 nozzles. Now you can buy a variety set too, but it comes with cleaning wires as well, which I don't use too much. I just replace them. But for the price, it works out to like 36 cents per nozzle. So very inexpensive. So why not replace it when you cut that PTFE tubing? When you replace the nozzle, I almost guarantee you're going to have to tweak the bed. You're going to have to re-level it. So just know that going in, but it's worth it. You're going to get better prints. Now, remember I mentioned the top of this should not be hot. If it is, then you need to take this cover off and look at your fan. And odds are there's going to be crap in there, or there's going to be little pieces of filament that may be slowing it down. You may have a broken blade. But if none of that is there and it's spinning and everything looks fine, but the top of this is still hot, replace the fan. I don't care what anybody tells you, replace the fan, because it's just not spinning properly. Now, you can get a set of fans. You can get one for the side for the cooling the filament, and then one that'll fit inside the case. And you can buy these in sets. I have a link to these as well in description. I buy them in sets of two sets, so I can fix two machines with these. These are by WINSINN. I'm not gonna say they're the quietest fans, but they're not bad either. And they last a lot longer than the Creality fans. So I haven't replaced the fans on mine very often. Now, the wires themselves are a little bit short. So I've shown this in a previous video. I actually just cut and spliced the fan to the existing wire. So I cut off the old one and I splice a new one in, and I use these solder sleeves that make it a lot easier to do this. You just heat it up with a heat gun and it solders it in place. So I highly recommend it. Now, these will sometimes fit tight within the case. You really got to pry it out sometimes. Sometimes it'll pop right out, but replace the fan. You'll be happy you did, and then the top of it will be cool, and you're going to get more consistent printing because you're going to get more consistent heating of the filament. The final thing you need to do is this gear on your extruder. Anytime you have resistance in that PTFE tubing or issues with that fan, that cooling, you're going to get grinding of the filament up here at the gear. And what you need to do before you start printing again is take a brush. Now, I like to take a stainless steel brush and I run it against it. Now, it's a brass gear on this, but the stainless steel for me seems to work better. I use a brass brush to clean the nozzle. I have a plastic brush to clean dust and stuff, but this one I use on the gear. All three of these are part of my Filament Friday toolkit. I'm not saying you got to go out and buy my kit. You can get these at any hardware store. They usually come in these three styles, but it's the stainless steel one. I just brush as I spin it, brush the teeth, and look for wear in the gear. If that gear is worn, replace it. But you can usually get away just by cleaning it and cleaning the filament out, because if you don't, it's going to start slipping, and then you're going to have problems. Even though you did everything right down here at the hot end, it's going to be slipping up here at the extruder, and you're going to be, why is it doing this? So clean that off. It's a real easy fix. I will put a link to all these items in the description below. They are affiliate links, so if you use them, it does help the channel. But if you don't want to use those, that's fine, as long as you buy the parts to fix your hot end so you can start printing good again. This is how you maintain the filament path, and it's very, very important, especially on a Creality machine, especially the Ender 3. Now, how does this happen, though, really? Well, if you ever lose power while it's printing, all that heat's got to go somewhere, because the fan's not blowing anymore. It goes right into the heat sink, it goes right into the nozzle, goes right into the PTFE tubing and starts to cook it. Also, if you're in a hurry, say it's printing and you have to shut it off and go somewhere, all that heat goes right into the PTFE tubing and the filament expands, causes you problems. If that fan should fail, where's the heat going? All into the PTFE tubing. So that's how it typically happens, or just, you know, printing over a long period of time, it just slowly wears out. If you do decide to replace the PTFE tubing, there's the standard PTFE, the clear stuff, so you can see the filament inside, and that's typically a 2 millimeter inside diameter. You can go with a Capricorn, which is what I have here. That's typically a 1.9 millimeter inside diameter, which is fine. The only issue I have with that is if you're printing with some filaments that have metal infused into it or wood infused, then you want a little bit bigger diameter. That's where this clear stuff is actually better. So it depends on what you're printing, but the Capricorn is higher temperature resistance, so you'll have to cut that off far less if you use it. And if you use that Luke Hatfield method that I showed in a previous video with just a little section, then all you have to do is pull out that little section, replace it, and you're back to printing. So there's a lot of options, but this is maintenance. This is what you have to do to keep your printer working properly and getting really good prints. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. That way you don't miss an episode. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.